In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to wash hands. I have a bowl for the washing of hands that will go with the soap. I have a rinsing bowl and I have a cloth for drying. First of all, you need to wet the soap and place it in the water. And while it's soaking up the water, I'm then going to soak my hands. I'm going to roll up my sleeves a little bit as well, so that I can get access to my wrists. I soak them a moment. I pick up the soap, and I swirl it round the palms, using my thumbs to push it round. You'll start to get a little lather on the palms and the fingers. Will show up white. Once you feel like you've got a strong lather, then you can put the soap down. By the way, if you want to join me in washing your hands as you do this video, then feel free. Now, I've got it on the palms, but I also need the soap on the back of that palm of hands as well. So I'll twist my hands and curl them over the backs of the hands. Don't forget the wrists. All the way up. And then in between the fingers to place the fingers spread like wings and to put them in between each other and slide them so that each part of the finger is covered too. Now, the aim of washing the hands is not to completely get rid of all the bacteria and grease, because that will never disappear. You'll never be able to get rid of all of that. But it is to get rid of the residue and the shallow dirt on the surface. Now, once you've done in between fingers, you've done the palms, you've done the backs of the hands, you've done the backs of the fingers, the thumbs as well need to be properly massaged too. You have two thumbs, so you'll have to do this twice, pulling the soap over the fingers. This hopefully will give clean and even lather across the entire hands. You also don't want the soap on your hands too much or too long, because it will dry out that skin and remove too much grease from the surface. And therefore, the skin will start to die on the outside. So it's important after a while to get rid of as much soap as you can in the water. But of course, at this point, the water will become very soapy and suddy, with bubbles popping up in it. So once you've rinsed them in the first bowl, the water is dirty. It's time then to move on to the next bowl. This clean water will rinse off any other residue that was accumulated on the skin. See how the water in this bowl is much clearer than the one in the sunny water on the left. Soak them and rinse them in this bowl. Don't forget the wrists. The same actions you were performing in the first bowl, you can do that in the second bowl too. And the skin quality will change. And you can hear some squeaks as the skin has changed its texture. once you feel you've got as much of the soot off as possible, then it's time to dry the hands. First of all, just shake them a little bit. So get rid of the majority of the droplets. And then to use a cloth to get the remnants of the water. Again, the same pattern, the palms first, rolling the cloth over the centers of the palms and the insides of the fingers, then the outsides of the hands. Don't forget the wrists, and then in between the fingers. The technique you use for the fingers to dry them can be more like how you were washing the thumbs, rolling the wrists and the fingers around the finger of the opposite hand. Every finger can be cleaned in this way, can be dried in this way. Once the hands are dried, then the process has been complete. And the hands should feel dry and clean. This is how to wash the hands.